today, John. We've had a lot of coaches and general managers talking about this whole quarterback issue. Last three Super Bowls, the highest drafted quarterback was a fourth rounder, Gannon. Now, what is your opinion? Do you pay the high money to get a franchise guy, or do you try and get one of those guys that makes smart decisions, gets rid of the football?
It took Gannon and Brad Johnson a long time to play at the level that they played at. If you got a chance to get a great quarterback at any round, pay the price and get him on your team. That's what I say.
He's the guy you start with.
Well, you got to have a great quarterback to win in this league. We all know that. And sometimes things go in cycles, I think, just like the last three or four Super Bowls.
Okay, now in this particular combine coming out this year, you've got Manning and Roethlisberger. People are putting that, quote, franchise tag on them. I know it's early in your evaluation process. Have you had a chance to watch some of them?
Looked at them and looked at some other guys. Rivers at NC State's a very good player. Drew Henson, who's a top flight quarterback at Michigan a couple years ago, is going to enter this draft in some capacity.
Right.
It's just a great year for quarterbacks, and unfortunately, I don't know if we have enough ammunition to get up there high enough to get one of these guys.
Now, when you come to this combine, all the fans out there thinking of the 40-yard dash, the bench press, philosophically, what are you looking to get out of this?
Well, obviously the physicals, you know, get the medical history on these players, learn a little bit about who they are as people. Their agents, where they're going to be on draft day, when their workouts are going to be.
Right.
And just to get an initial impression on how firm the handshake is, what the eye contact is like, and how much they love football.
It's interesting. We had a couple guys on yesterday, and they were talking about the look. And you're famous for having a look, but they're all saying, hey, we want to see a kid look in the eye, firm handshake. I mean, do you really get that deep into it?
Yeah, you know, you don't have a long time. Everybody's lobbying for interview time, but the sincerity, the answers that you're looking for,
right.
the look in a man's eye, and you know, those are things that sometimes you can get in a first impression.
There's over 300 kids here. Is in your head, when you're talking to your coaches, your scouts, is there a type of player that's a Buccaneer player?
Yeah, we're not going to let that secret out. You know, we want we're looking for guys that love the game, that have great aspirations, that want to become tremendous football players and be on a United football team, and guys that like physical football and obviously love the game.
Right. Yeah. Last question. History has taught us that it's really hard to repeat a Super Bowl champion. It's just hard to sustain that excellence. Can you tell the fans out there some of the challenges that they might not understand why it's so difficult in today's NFL?
Well, it's a competitive league. You know, the salary cap, the way the league is set up, it makes it very difficult to maintain any kind of continuity, and it's a great challenge. Obviously, there's so much parity between the NFC and the AFC and in these interconference games, anything can happen. And if you get a few injuries, you lose a few guys to free agency, maybe you don't win the tight games like you did the year before.
Right.
But it's a challenge.
Okay. Well, listen, we appreciate you stopping by, John, and good luck this year.
Thank you. Thanks. Appreciate it.